It's Breakfast with Eric and Claire. Joining us now is a man who claims he has an encyclopedic knowledge of new houses built in the 60s through to the 90s in Shropshire. He calls himself the New House Historian. He's from Telford and his name is Steve Bowers. Hello.
Hello, how
Thank
are
you? Thank you very much for coming in. Where did this passion for houses come from?
I'll tell you what, back in 1987, when I was a kid and I was at school, and some housing leaflets appeared on the outside window, and the teacher said to me, "Today we're going to design a house." And I thought, oh, that sounds interesting. I'm going to tell you something now, it's a secret. I copied a house from a housing estate in Lee Gomery, and it won the competition.
Oh, come on!
Seriously, that's what happened.
Did you really?
How long ago is this?
This was 1987.
So you feel better for confessing that now?
I do. I've carried that round with me for years. And so I did that, and then I just got this passion for houses then. And then I started, as a kid, trying to get in these show homes. And there's one where we lived in on the other side of Brookside. And I go in there and I go, "I'm doing a project on school about houses. And would I be able to look in the show home?" I mean, now we've turned it into a business because I review show homes for a living.
Do you really? And how wonderful.
I've
seen your site.
You have, Show Homes Online, it's called.
I've seen it.
Yeah,
seen it.
And we go all over the country doing it, and that new show home smell, I can still remember it, is still the same as it ever has been.
How fabulous.
And so I started sort of looking at different types of houses and things, and I yearned to live in a new house. I was like, oh, that's, you know, because I lived on a council estate, and across the road was the what we called, the, well, my mum and dad called, the private houses. I was always like, I had no aspiration to live in one. I was like, I'm going to live in one of those one day.
Do you?
Yes, we live in a new. It's a newish house, but yeah. It's funny, the house that I live in, I've got the brochure for, and I had the brochure in my archive for ages, and you'd have thought all these years later I'd be living in that house. How strange is that?
So your life is houses, really?
It is, and even to the point that this is even really, really, really strange, that I've even had a house named after me.
That's
I'll
amazing.
Show it, yeah. I'll show it you.
What is the Steve Bower House?
No, it's just called The Bowers.
Yay! I love it.
Was
That's
that really,
fantastic.
Honestly,
that is,
named after you?
But do you know, a company that we did a review for called Walton Homes in Staffordshire, they had this wish list thing they did, and they said, and they put it out there, and I thought, you know what? I'd love to have a house named after me. And then all of a sudden, they come back to me, and they're actually going to send the laminate of the sales. So people are living, there's people living in the Bowers House now. And I actually quite like the design as well.
Steve, stay right there.
I love it.
We're going to talk to you
some
more.
I'm fine.
After 8:30.
Our new house historian is still with us. He is from Telford. His name is Steve Bowers. He's got an encyclopedic knowledge of houses from when he cheated in that competition at the school.
Oh, don't say that. That's actually, look.
You did, though. You told us you did.
I did. That's the, I don't know, you can't see this.
Cause, no, because
this
radio.
Is the original. This was the original leaflet that was on the wall. That one there. 1985. See the date on that?
Of your house?
Of the house that was on the competition.
Oh, the one that,
that was the picture that inspired
me. He's showing us a drawing of a house from a...
He did a competition at school to design a house, and he nicked the plans, from a new house.
I did.
And designed it and won the competition.
I did.
What's it called?
The Uskdale.
Uskdale.
The Uskdale. A lot of developers have come and gone. And
they
that
don't ask us some strange names for houses, don't they?
Like
they do, actually.
The called Bowers.
Well, Bowers
now.
Is fine. Uskdale.
Yeah, the Bowers. There's...
Yeah. Listen. Do you make a living out of reviewing houses?
Yes. But the company we run is Show Homes Online, and what we do is we go into show homes and we almost critique them and sort of talk about how our house. My wife's more into interior design, so she comments on how the house looks and how the furniture etc. goes in there. And we look at stuff like stupid things like, you know, does your sofa go there? Does real furniture fit in one of these houses?
Because I've been in show houses, and so have you, where they have smaller furniture.
Oh!
Yes. And they take the doors off to make it look bigger.
Oh, they do.
And that's
the sort of
thing we actually report back on, you see. So we kind of speak to developers and say, you know, you know, this is what we've seen. And they actually take us through some, when we have got some big clients now. One of my wife said hundreds of thousands of people watch us, looking at us, looking at houses. And people have said, we've bought houses because of your reviews.
I've looked because one of my lads has moved into a new house about 8-9 months ago now. And we were looking at a new house, and we saw, and we looked at his new house effectively on your site.
Because we
could have a look around, see?
Yeah, and we review houses all over the country. Yeah, yeah. So we try to get developers' portfolios. They pay us for our impartial opinion.
Impartial?
Yes, impartial. So we can say they like that because it looks like... Well, it appears that we look normal. We're normal people. Okay. We're just anybody.
So you're not afraid to say that doesn't work?
No. And if we saw a really serious problem, we would always go back and have a meeting with them and discuss those. Because that's how it all happened, is we did a review for a house and estate in Bicester, I better say it properly. And they were horrified, this company were. Yeah, yeah. And they called us in for a meeting. And lo and behold, they said, well, actually, we'd like you to come forward and review our houses and feedback what you see, because they're not always to the standard that you would expect them to be.
Quite. Did you not know they put smaller furniture in, Shire?
I didn't know.
Did you not know that? No. Did you not know they took doors off?
I know they took the doors off.
Did you not know they don't put a telly in the lounge?
If you watch on our reviews, you'll see that Emma's the first one to point out the bed. So she
put small doubles in.
Yeah.
So smallest double bed you can get.
Yeah.
And then you never see a telly in the lounge.
Why?
Because it just gets...
Because it takes up room?
Of course it does.
Show them tricks.
Interesting. I shall now sit and look at them in a different light.
They tell me you know all about houses.
Well, I've got a fair idea.
What do you know about the estate that we sit on here?
Well this is called... I think it's called Mount Pleasant. It was built by Fletcher Homes. Yeah. One of Shropshire's largest house builders in the time. And they built many, many different housing estates here. All over Shropshire, Washford Park, Sundown Grove. Huge developer. Looking at me now, look.
What did they sell for, do you know?
Well, some of these were, and I think they're in the region of, about 24,000.
24?
Back in the day. Am I out?
Like miles out.
Oh, guess all right then.
Telford Estate, down the road. Telford Estate. That's Fletcher's.
Yep, Fletcher's.
Freehold. £2,485.
Oh, hang on a minute. Oh, yes.
What year are we in here?
1974.
Yeah. Bang on right with that. 74. Yeah.
74.
Right, yeah. We bought a house once from a company called Second City Homes. Do you know about them?
I do. Yeah. I actually do know Second City. Unfortunately, gone. Beanie.
So I can tell you the house was rubbish.
Where did you buy it? Where's the house?
About a mile and a half down the road, yeah.
Oh, hang on.
Herongate.
Herongate. Yeah. Oh, yes.
It was awful.
Naturally, Herongate's quite funny because a lot of people call it Herongate, but there was various different developers on that site.
Big site.
And all the different developers had different names.
Yep.
And it was Second City that started the site, and that's how it got its name, Herongate, because their development was called Herongate.
It was that rubbish. If you slid down the banister when we moved in, you get spells in your bottom.
They were big though.
Weren't they good though?
Well, they evolved into another developer, which aren't much better themselves.
So from your school competition,
yeah,
designing that house, who'd have known that you'd have been doing this right now?
It is surreal. When I'm in a house now, when I'm looking, I'm actually inside a show home, it doesn't seem real that we're doing it. It really doesn't. And it's it's such an enjoyable job because we're helping people buy houses. And you're looking, when you're buying a car, you look at thousands of reviews. When you're buying a house, which is a purchase now, a nice hefty price, you know, you want to do your homework, don't you?
Good to see you, Steve. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. There he is, the new house historian from Telford, Steve Bowers. He and his wife doing house reviews. He knows all about the house, perhaps, that you're living in, if it's relatively new anyway. Okay.